स्टूडेंट्स, सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस व्हाट इज़ पीएलसी। सो पीएलसी बेसिकली प्रोग्रामेबल लॉजिक कंट्रोलर, बाय इट्स फुल फॉर्म ओनली वी कैन से दैट इट इज़ अ लॉजिक कंट्रोलर। मीन्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ प्रोग्रामिंग वी कैन यूज, बाय यूजिंग सम लॉजिक्स वी कैन कंट्रोल एनी डिवाइस और एनी प्रोसेस। सो इन दिस सीरीज वी विल लर्न व्हाट इज़ पीएलसी, its history, its major components, its operation of sequence, some ladder logic diagrams, logics, some examples, advantages, disadvantages, applications and etc. So let's start with the definition. So what is PLC? PLC is a digital computer designed for multiple inputs and outputs arrangements, extended temperature ranges, immunity to electrical noise and resistant to vibration and impact, and it is a real time system. So with this definition, what it says with this definition, so PLC is a digital computer. It is a digital computer designed for multiple inputs and output arrangements. Means at the input end we can provide any number of inputs and we can take any number of outputs. So it does not depend on the other factor, but in simple language that many inputs can be given to this device and many outputs can be taken out from this device. So basically from this definition, it is a multiple input and multiple output arrangements. It has multiple or extended temperature ranges, means any type of higher temperature or lower temperature, any type of temperature ranges can be used in this PLC system. It helps in defining in electrical noise. So if any electrical noise is there in the system, so this device can easily capture that device and provide information to the admin or the operator who is operating that system. And are resistant to vibrations, also it provide a resistance free system to the user, so that the process can be easily output can be easily made and the system can be easily function. Yeah, it's function. So basically if I say in a simple language, it is a real time system. Real time, what is real time system? So real time system is a means, let's say an example, a very simple example. If a tap is open and it is filling a bucket, okay, it's a very simple language. When I open a tap and the tap starts filling the bucket, so if I am seeing it in front, in my front only, so I can see it is filling the bucket. If I am not there, let's say if I am not there, I am outside with some work, okay, then the bucket is filling. How should I know that the bucket is filling? So it shows if I have system PLC and SCADA, okay, both systems I have there with me, both system I have with me, so I can automatically means with my system, let's say I have access to PLC on my mobile, okay, so I can in my mobile I can see the real time, means how much the bucket is filled, how, when to start the tap, when to stop the tap, so that the bucket can should not overflow. So it is a real time. The basic definition is it's a real time system, okay. So let's see some history in 3 points, okay, very short time. Introduced in 1960s, okay, so the first PLC was introduced in 1960 for commercial and success. It is actually used for a commercial use, and it was a successful programmable logic controller, first successful logic controller was designed and developed by Medicon. Okay, it's designed and developed by Medicon as a relay replacer. Means earlier they were used to in industry, there huge relays are used which has very high weights. So by for that it was a some cons are there, the it has some cons. So for that replacement of relays, we the programmable logic controller was used, first logic controller was used, and which is developed by Medicon as a relay replacer. First PLC was introduced by Medicon as a relay replacer for General Motors. For the company name is General Motors, which designed very large planes, engines and motors and all stuff you can see online. Okay, so earlier it was a machines with thousands of electronic parts. So basically, as I said that earlier, instead of relays, they were used as a the commercial relays were used, which has many disadvantages, and like time, it shows time, means the process takes some time to show, to display to the user, means it causes some delay in the output. So that's why this new types of relay which is manufactured now, so there are many advantages over the conventional relays. Conventional relays means the old relays. So and also earlier there were so many machine means wiring were used, so that if any kind of fault occurs in the relay, then it was a bit confusing for the operator, or that which wire has damaged or all that. So it takes much time and it's very time consuming also. So the development should means the new relay should be introduced so that the process can be very easily, and we can save much of time. So that's why the PLC has many advantages. So from these advantages, I just told three points. So the next part is the major component of PLCs. So the major component of PLC, with the help of this diagram, see the diagram. Okay, in between it is a processor. Okay, so what is a processor? So the basic processor is the programmable programmable microprocessor, right? We used to see the chips and all that. So it is a processor which can store the programming, okay, which can process the information given to the processor, okay, means with the help of the programming device which is connected below. Okay, with the help of this programming device, we can process the informations, any kind of information. Let's see one example, that if we have to add two numbers, A and B, okay, A can be any number, B can be any number. So A and B, so we can write this program and code it. Okay, code it means coding means programming. So by coding this device, we can process them, means A and B, okay, right? A and B. So if I say A is 5 and B is 2, right? So I have given this both the numbers to the programming device, but now we have to add this number or subtract. Let's say add, okay? So we have to add this number A plus B. So who will process this calculation? Okay, this will the processor will process this calculation, right? So the amount, the value given to the programming device is given to the processor, which process the information and send it to the output. So it has also in the left side it is a input module, okay, and the right side it is a output module, okay. So input module is discuss about power supply. So what is power supply? Means if we have to operate this PLC, right, if we have to operate this PLC, then we have to give power supply, okay. So the power supply is given to the processor, right? Processor is given, it has to we have to give power to the processor, input module and output module, because they have many electronics components for operation. for their operations. Means it is completely made up of tiny electronics components which need supply. So that supply is given by this power supply. Now there is an input module and output module. Okay, the input module is on the left side. So what are the inputs given, should be given to the PLC. I'll discuss some examples that from as in the previous example I have said that there is a bucket filling, right? So in my mobile I can see that the bucket is filling, how to stop, and we have to stop that bucket so that overflow can not happen. Okay, so there should be some sensors connected there. Okay, means there will be some sensors connected that sense the water level of the bucket. In that example, we have to just sense the level of the bucket. Okay, if the bucket is almost full and we have to stop it, okay, then that sensor should sense the information and should be given to this input module. Okay, input module, and for that stopping we should write the program in programming device, and that should be executed by the processor, and the output should be the processed output is given to the output module, and which automatically stops the tap. Means there is some modern electronic arrangement should be there so that it can stop with the help of PLC. So from sensors, like push buttons are there, right? Push buttons is also a input type, right? We have to just push the button so that the motor should be on. Let's say an example that if I press the button, then motor should be on. If I release the button, it should run. Okay, but if I press another, if let's say there are two buttons so that the motor can be on, okay, for water pumping the water from the well. Okay, so there are red button and a green button, so that, okay, so if I press green button, okay, then the green button will allow the motor to operate and it start pumping the water in the overhead tanks and the water will fill. Then if I have to stop the water, then there are some sensors connected, right? If in the tank, water tank, overhead tank, there are sensors connected which sense the water level, and it will automatically supply to this PLC. This PLC will sense sensed signal is passed to the PLC input module, and then the signal is processed and executed in processor, and it is controlled through output module. Push buttons are there, contactors are there, limit switches are there, and many more are there. Okay, then these are some inputs. There are actually many numbers of inputs we can use to operate. Any kind of inputs we can provide so that we can control the output. Like major industries, if we say that electrical substations are there, which has many many electrical parts with electronics part. Substation has many means isolators are there, transformer are there. So there, in that case, the PLC should be implemented. PLC and SCADA, both. PLC and SCADA should be implemented here so that it can easily sense the fault or any kind of damage to the system. It should easily capture or sense that signal and should send the signal to the automation engineer, right? So that he can control, or automatically it should be controlled. Okay, so the output on the right hand side, it is the output module. What is output module? The output module through which the output is taken, means the executed, the processed information through processor is given to the output module. What is output module? Output module is normally means the connection to which we have to control it, right? In the previous example, as we have seen that through tap we are controlling the water level of the bucket, right? So the bucket is almost filled. Okay, the output is connected, should connected to the tap. In a very basic example, I'll say if it is connected to the tap, Okay, so the executed information, the process information is given to the tap. Tap will automatically solve this issue. Okay, so what are outputs? Some examples are solenoids, right? Contractors, alarms, etc. In alarm, if there is a fire in the building, right? If there are sensors connected, then that sensors will automatically sense that information, and it will start. It will give signals to alarm, and automatically trip. If there are installed safety devices like automatic trip devices, then it will automatically trip the trip the circuit and starts sprinkling the water if there is a water system, safety water system installed in the building. So it will give alarm, means it start making noise very rapidly so that we can know that there is a fire in the alarm. Now let's see in basic all the parts. Power supply provide power, so voltage needed to run the primary PLC components, right? As I have discussed that all the primary components used in the PLC should be given power supply. The next is input module provide signal conversion and isolation between internal logic level signals inside the PLC and field high level signals, right? Provide signal conversion. It provides signal conversion means if we are getting any signal in the form of voltage or current or any other, then it should be converted to the understandable logic so that we can understand, right? The coming information from the sensor will be in analog, right? So that signal should be reached to us, but we can't understand, right? So it should be converted. So it should be converted and will be processed by processor. Okay, the processor will then only understand that this has happened. The next is the processor. Processor is provides intelligence to command and governs the activities of the entire PLC system, right? Provide intelligence to the command means the command we have given, right? If we have to stop the system, we should give the stop command, right? So that the processor can process that command, right? Processor can process that stop command given to it, right? So, and it also control all the basic activities of the PLC. Means all, if there is fault, then it can automatically stop the, automatically process that information and provide to us. And it displays many other component, shows. And it actually not displays, it actually process that information which we provide to them, which commands to them, right? If I give them a stop signal, it will stop. If I provide start command, it will start the process. If I provide hold command, that it will hold the process. So there are actually many number of commands which we can provide to the PLC, right? The next one is the programming device used to enter desired program, right? It is used to enter the desired program. So as I have said in the two examples, that if I have to maintain that water level in the bucket half, so if I'll provide I should write I will write the program, right? There are many programming language, we will discuss it later. So I will enter a program in the programming device that it can automatically stop until the bucket is filled half, that it will okay. So in this lecture or in this video I have discussed some basics, all the basics of PLC, and basics of what are the components used in the PLC, some history, like it is introduced in 1960s, Medicon company which has manufactured the first PLC as a replacement of the conventional relays, and it has also replaced all the thousands of electrical parts which we used earlier. So it has replaced all that. So it has many more advantages than the conventional PLCs. Also We have discussed power supply, input-output module, processor, programming device, and all the other basics with examples we have discussed. So, I hope you like the video. Thank you.